Number three, we have find the distance traveled in one back and forth swing of a weight of a 12-inch pendulum that swings through a 75-degree angle. Okay, this is no longer a sphere problem. This is now, a review problem. So let's try to draw what we have. Okay, we have a pendulum. You know those little pendulums, right? And the balls go back and forth. Okay, this pendulum is swinging at 75 degrees. The length of the pendulum is 12 inches. Okay, find the distance traveled in one back and forth movement. So what am I finding? What is this part of a curve called? Is that sector area or arc length? I hope you're saying arc length. But the trick on this one is we're not finding it in one direction, but we're finding it over and back. So whatever we get, we're going to double. Okay? So remember the formula. The measure over 360 times, and remember the arc length is part of the circumference, so d pi. Okay, so what's our diameter if our pendulum swing is 12? Well, that would be 24, wouldn't it? So the diameter is 24. 24 pi over 1, and the measure is 75 over 360. So let's just kind of clean that up a little bit, okay? 75 divided by 360, and we'll get that into a nice reduced fraction. 5/24, okay, so I just reduced that. 5/24 times 24 over pi, or times pi over 1. Oh, how handy. That cancels out, doesn't it? So 24s cancel, and I'm left with 5 pi. Now remember, that's only one swing. That's just over. So I've got to take that and multiply it by 2, so I'm going to get 10 pi. Now notice, I don't have 10 pi there because this is not in terms of pi. So I'm going to have to multiply 10 times 3.14. Well, you should recognize it. What's 10 times 3.14? It's D, 31.4. So there we go. Okay, so there are the first three. The first